I'm violinist Shane Kim of the Toronto Symphony Orchestra. The piece you just heard me play is called Love's Joy by Fritz Kreisler, and it's a piece I love to play because it captures the feeling of happiness that I get when I play my favorite instrument in the world, the violin. I'm so happy to be spending some time with you today because I'm excited to talk to you about how the violin makes sound. After I do that, we're going to do a little activity that you can do at home. But first, let's take a closer look at the violin. Now, as you can see, the violin has many interesting and beautiful looking parts. But the parts I want to focus on are the violin bow, the strings, and the violin bridge. The hair on the bow rubs against the violin string, causing it to vibrate like this. Those vibrations travel down the bridge to the violin, causing the whole violin to vibrate. And that causes the air inside the violin to vibrate. And that is how we get the beautiful violin sound. So I know not all of you have a violin at home, so I have a simple activity that we can do to help explain what I'm talking about. So come on, let's go. I have some assistants waiting for me in the other room. So these are my three very smart assistants, and they're going to be helping me play a very simple musical instrument that you can create at home. So my assistants have filled their glasses with some water, and I'm going to ask them to wet their finger and gently rub the lip of their glasses. Let's see what happens. Ooh. How about you? Oh, that sounds cool. Sounds lower. Nice. That's amazing. Like magic, these glasses with water make music. But is it really magic? Let me explain what's really happening. The finger is like the violin bow, and it rubs the lip of the glass, which is kind of like the string on a violin. And those vibrations travel down the side of the entire glass, and then the whole glass vibrates. And then those vibrations cause the air to vibrate. And that is what creates the sound. If you want to get a better look at the vibrations that I'm talking about, here's a little trick that you can try. Try rubbing the glass slowly. See how the water bubbles? That's because of the vibrations in the glass. So the last thing I want to try is to recreate some of the notes from the violin with the glasses. So before we start, who knows how many strings a violin has?
Four
strings, that's right. And some of the strings sound low and some of them sound high. So if we want to change what the glass sounds like, what can we do?
We're controlling the sound, you put the amount of water.
That's right. So you can change the sound of the glass by changing the amount of water that you put in the glass. And so, if we want a note to sound low, what do we do?
You put more water.
More water. And if you want a note to sound high?
You put less water.
That's right. So, if you want a note to sound low, you put lots of water. If you want a note to sound high, then you put less water. Now, we have four strings on the violin, but we have three glasses. So, we've recreated the D, we've recreated the A, and the E. So let's give this a shot. Who has the D? Very good. So next we have the A. Mm-hmm. that sounds super low because there's so much water in the glass. And finally, we have the E. That's great. That comes through really clearly. Nice work, guys. High five. So I want to thank you for spending some time with me and my kids today. I really hope you learned something new and, most importantly, had fun playing music. So that's all for today. I hope to see you at a Toronto Symphony Orchestra concert soon. Bye.
Bye.